Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Wes Bunn, and I'm a technical writer here at Epic Games. And over the next several videos, we're going to be working together to build our very own third-person game entirely from scratch. So starting with just some FBX assets, we'll go through the import process here together to get those assets inside Unreal Engine 4. And then we'll build everything else that we need around that to get our character up and running around in our level here. So this video series is aimed at beginners, so if you are new to Unreal Engine 4 and would like to learn how to get your own characters into the editor and playable, this is the video series for you. Did want to mention that we are using Unreal Engine version 4.8 for the purposes of this video series. So with that, let's actually take a look at the finished project here. So if I jump into the editor here and hit play, we'll show you what it is we're going to try to create here together. So you can see we have our character here who is idling, and I can rotate a camera around him, which is pretty standard for any third-person game, having a follow camera essentially. So we can independently control that. And we can also use the W, A, S, and D keys to run around with our character. And we can go back to an idle state. So we'll show you how to set this up to get your character running around inside your game. And then we can also jump with our character here. And we can jump to different heights. So we can jump from here, we can jump there, we can jump all the way down here like so. So we can show you how to set that up as well. And then you can also see as our character is running around, he's kicking up a little bit of dust here, which is kind of cool. So we'll show you to set up this particle effect that occurs whenever the player is running. So we'll do that towards the end of the video. First things first, we need to get our character up and running before we do anything else. And then we'll also show you how to do some punches with a character. Now, these punches aren't the greatest looking, but it gets the job done. It shows you how you can set this up, where I can do like one punch at a time, or I can hold it down and do multiple punches. And I can also punch and run at the same time. So if your game, you have a character that you want to run and shoot or run and reload, this will show you how to set that up. Our character can also punch stuff because that's cool. Look at that, get out of here. So that's what it is we want to create here together. This is the end result. There's a lot of systems that come into play here and work together that we're gonna have to touch upon. So I wanted to run through those really quickly to kind of show you what it is we're going to be covering and give you a brief description on what they are before we get into them. So as you can see, we have a lot to cover. So starting from the top here to the bottom, the first thing that we're going to be taking a look at is the importing process and importing FBX files, how you can get your FBX assets into Unreal Engine 4 and start working with them. From there, we're going to be taking a look at skeleton assets, what they are and how they work, as well as some things to keep in mind when sharing skeletons between characters. From there, we're going to take a look at Persona, which is the animation tool inside Unreal Engine 4. And then we'll talk about how to properly set up inputs on a character. So how to go into your project settings and add the inputs that you need so that you can use them later. This will include setups for gamepads and touch controls, as well as the standard PC controls or mouse and keyboard style controls. We're then going to look at blend spaces and show a way that you can blend between multiple animations based on really a variety of factors. But we're going to do it based on the speed of the character. So you can go from like an idle state into a walk, into a run, and transition between all three states smoothly. From there, we're going to take a look at animation blueprints. So how you get the data from the game or from the character blueprint, which is another topic for discussion, and take that data and essentially transition that into the final animation that your character is actually doing. From there, we're going to take a look at state machines, which are a way that you can create sort of a flowchart or a graph of all the different states or things that your character is going to be doing and smoothly move between them and set up rules to transition between each state. And a lot more information will be coming on that when we actually get to that video. It's sort of a beast of a topic, so it's going to have its own video once we get to that later in the series. And then, as I mentioned, we're going to take a look at setting up a character blueprint. And not only that, but how a character blueprint is different than a pawn blueprint. For a lot of people who are just getting into Unreal Engine 4, particularly if you're from like had a history in UDK or Unreal Engine 3, a lot of folks don't really know which of those two to begin with when setting up a character, a pawn or a character blueprint. So we're going to talk about that and help clarify some things and why you may want to choose one over the other. So as you can see, we have a lot to cover, but we'll try to break up these videos into bite-sized chunks so that it's more easily digestible. But ultimately, our end goal is to get all the way back to here so that we have a playable character that can run around, jump, and punch. So that's going to do it for this video. In the next video, we will show you where you can get your hands on some of the assets that we will be using for the purposes of this series. And in that video, we will start the FBX import process. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in the next video.